Welcome to Fresh, the best place for a platter of Pacific goodness right here with us. I hope you're all set to sit back and relax with us and enjoy this amazing poly feast.
That's right, because we're keeping it fresh and sharing a little bit of our world.
Here's what's coming up on Fresh.
My name's Tiki Tani, here I am. We're at On The Lawn Festival, celebrating life and music, keeping it fresh, yo.
Mysterious girl.
Oh my God.
Oh yeah, man, I was in love with
it. Come across, it's a real dark night.
So one cool beach spot is the Mount. You guys ever been?
No, I haven't. I'm from the South Island, but I'll go there one day with you.
Yeah, I haven't either, but I might have to jump in on that trip.
Oh my God. Okay, so Rhea Hoare, Holly Smith, they're all living down there, and in particular, Tiki Tane, who's keeping it fresh on the lawn.
Kia ora koutou katoa. My name's Tiki Tani, here I am, my hometown of Mount Maunganui. We're at On The Lawn Festival, celebrating life and music, keeping it fresh, yo. Beautiful fresh food, fresh music, fresh company, it's all good.
Yeah, thank you so much.
We're keeping it fresh with black legs and white chucks.
So that's the thing, man. Just take your time and enjoy everything. I mean, there's so much beautiful food here. I mean, you're not going to be able to eat it all. Have a little bit in the morning, take a break, have a little bit in the afternoon, have a little bit at night, you know what I mean? Pace yourself.
Kia ora, freshies.
Hey, everyone.
I'm Karina, and this is Casey, and we're here today at On The Lawn. Make a gourmet hangi. They've been going off. We've, like, jazzed them up with some salsa verde. We've got our pork belly, chicken, and blue cheese sauce. So, you know, make old classics a little bit fresh like that. Here you go, and here's some cutlery for you as well.
For most people, you're probably thinking it's about the hangi part, but it's actually about the sauces. Flavours are amazing. Salsa verde on the pork belly. Green mode.
I just got the pan-fried dumplings from the Johnny's Dumplings House because I've been spying on them for a good 20 minutes and they look delicious.
Fried chicken burger from the American Rye Place, it's delicious. Yum.
My new single, which is called No Place Like Home, is basically, it's inspired by this area, Bay of Plenty, Te Moana Toi, and my love of this area and the fact that the community is welcoming me into this place. So, you know, coming to places like this, events like this, I'm showcasing local food, beverages, things like that. There's even some local acts.
Hey, we're Yokozuna, we're here on the lawn and we're keeping it
fresh.
Every time we come down, you gotta keep it fresh, climb the mountain.
As soon as anyone mentions swimming, you must go swimming, whether it's like it's in the harbour or in the little pond, you've gotta go swimming.
Hey there, we're Sal Valentine and the Baby Shakes, keeping it fresh.
Everything's been amazing, everyone's been thumbs up, supportive, so I'm really stoked, I'm really humbled to be able to write a song about essentially an area that I'm going to be living in for the rest of my life and my kids will be living in, and it's just been a really awesome kaupapa and project. So my fresh life tip is something that I've carried around with me for a long, long time, and it is, you can't fly like an eagle if you're knocking around turkeys.
Do you guys have any beach tips?
Yes, take some sunblock. But also take some coconut oil. You want to get brown.
Yeah.
Yeah. Also, make sure that you find a beach where there's some fresh water or a shower, outdoor shower, you can rinse off all the sand.
But that's after you've gone surfing, or at least got a body surfing. You want a beach with some break.
Yeah. Oh, and a fella, not like a guy, a mat that you can sit on, you know, and keep protected and relax.
Ain't nobody got time for that.
Here's some island tips for you.
And a welcome to the island tip, the segment where you learn a few things of advisors in case you go to the island. This week, our island tip is how to find a beach spot. Now, when the whole family has rocked up to the beach in a van and it's been a long trip, your father's job is to find a perfect spot for a picnic. He looked left, he looked right, he's like a $6 million man. And then he find it. Pinky, there it is. It's a perfect spot. Now these are the things that to consider when you're looking for a perfect beach spot. Number one, make sure there's a tree to tie the volleyball net to, and also to providing a shade for you to keep a cooler. Number two, make sure you're very close to the toilet or the changing room. If you cut a cake, you don't want it to be 10 miles away. Number three, make sure you're a little bit higher than the sand, otherwise the sand gonna be blow on your feet. And make sure you're kind of close to the water, so your eyes can see the kids while they're swimming. Well, your mum will see you kids while you're swimming. And then number four, make sure there's a little few hills just to break the wind. Otherwise, the wind's gonna blow everything away, and we're watching your mum be carried away with the umbrella like Mary Poppins. Well, that's my island tip for this week. Tune in next week for more advices on our island tips. Thank you.
Cool. That was cool. What are your guys' best festival moments?
Okay, so for me, it's any festival where there's a really good feed. Like, I'm not gonna lie.
Yeah.
As long as there's a good feed, I'm happy.
Yeah, mine was probably Coachella. I went last year. I saw Kanye West popped out in the middle of the weekend set. That was fun.
Oh my gosh, Polyfest. Oh. Best food.
Fijian curry at the Fijian stand at Pacifica. I obviously love food. I'm not gonna lie, I love my food.
Fried bread. You gotta try the fried bread. Ooh. With a big slab of butter. Not too much and in moderation, guys.
Yum.
All right, I'll see you guys after the break.
Like, a Bond girl should be a Polynesian girl, because hello, like, hello.
If Halle Berry can do it, I can do it.
Exactly.
Ni Zhan, Ni Zhan.
Bro, who's this?
Oh, this is my sister's kids. Yeah, this is my Ni Zhan, my nephew.
Ni Zhan?
Yeah. Head, shoulder, knee, chanters, knee, chanters, knee, chanters. Head, shoulder, knee, chanters, eyes, ears, ears and mouth.
Knees and toes.
So I finished Shorty at the end of 2014. That was a big deal. And then I got a role on Wentworth. And then I did 1,000 Ropes. I did my first theatre show in February. I really enjoyed it. It's fun.
I did stuff with Spartacus, but this is my first big role. From day one, from the get-go, when the trailer was released, it's just gone boom.
After Sione's wedding too, I got to work on The Last Saint. I loved it so much. Got my first lead girl role on Tatal. Straight after that, I got to work on Shannara Chronicles. After that, I got my second TV show with Filthy Rich. So we'll see what happens next.
My first acting gig was Shorten Street.
Nice, right.
I got that. I was in high school and I was just in drama class one day and my teacher was like, oh, they're looking for someone to play Robbie Mangasiva's daughter, and everyone's like, Frankie! And I was like, no. But my best friends dragged me along
eventually
on the day, and the rest is history.
We met on Sione's too. We
were Sione's wedding too, yeah.
Holy angels.
And these beautiful, like, young models came through, and they were real giggly, and I was real serious. So I was like, shush, they're trying to take, like, we, you know, we're messing it up.
I know where I'm going. I'm going straight for Xena. I was a Xena girl. I used to run around the house going, ah!
Oh my goodness.
And she had coloured eyes, so I'm like, yeah, we're twinning.
I was too busy being obsessed with Janet Jackson from like day one. I learned every dance, every song. I'd write down the lyrics, you know, push pause on the cassette.
I was obsessed with Siobhan Ruakere on What Now, who is now my friend. She was like my favourite person to watch on TV ever. And Jonathan Taylor Thomas from Home Improvement, he was like my first crush. And we never fell in love, so.
Okay, it's not TV or anything, but honestly, when that song came out, Mysterious Girl. Yeah, man, I was in love with him. I was like, just pretending I'm that girl in the waterfall.
Dreams are free.
With my character, the changeling on Shannara, the Shannara Chronicles, they wanted her to be able to move quite fiercely and also wear no clothes. Which I was like, okay, I can do that. You just, she's going to be body painted, but it was quite minimal. And in my mind, I thought about Mystique from X-Men and how she was, and I was like, she can do that, I can do that, you know. But that was cool and interesting, and every day I was scared but excited at the same time because it's so out of my comfort zone, and I knew they were going to make it look awesome.
And I think it's so important to like put yourself out of your comfort zone, which is, I feel like I get to do that way too much in this job, but it's great because you learn a lot about yourself too.
Yeah, for sure.
I'm so proud of New Zealanders, eh? And yeah, especially the young, you know, the people coming up, you know. We always got to look up to like what Cliff Curtis, Midiyama Smith, heaps of beautiful people, and this is the next generation coming through. Yeah.
No, it's quite interesting, like the idea of Hollywood and then like the reality of it are two completely different things. And now, like, ultimately my goal would be to do extremely well overseas, but in films that, you know,
mean something.
Yeah, that really mean something. I really like New Zealand, but I didn't really appreciate it as much until I left and did some travel and realised how awesome it was to have as a home. Yeah.
Polynesians as a whole are working together now though, rather than like Samoa's over here, you know, and you know, the Cook Islands are doing their thing, Tonga's doing their thing, everybody, especially in New Zealand, you work together.
I'd like to see Polynesian women playing leads, just
written by Poly people as well.
Like a Bond girl should be a Polynesian girl because hello.
Holly
Berry can do it, I can do it.
Exactly. Here's what's coming up on Fresh.
You know, just go for a walk, hold hands. So after that, you'll always improve.
I love the holding hands. I don't know about the walking.
Metaphors. Metaphors.
Metaphors. Be with you.
The force is strong with this one, mate.
Welcome back to Fresh, where we're talking about our perfect first dates, or not.
Yeah, don't bring your flatmates, guys.
Oh, what's your perfect first date, Shay?
make sure there's food.
Yeah.
I love food.
And I think be thoughtful. Like, as long as you're genuine and if you're confident.
Not you too confident.
No, don't be cocky, but be confident. Don't come all in, check out my muscles. Yes, no, not going to work.
Some sort of conversation, I think, is good.
Yeah, you've got to be able to talk.
It's got to be intellectual stimulation.
Yeah. Because if you're pretty, honey, and you ain't got no brains, we ain't going far.
Also, at a decent hour, it's not a really cool one if it's a day.
Yeah. And absolutely, do not say Netflix and chill. Like, no. Should we see what the boys had to say about their first day?
Oh, yes. Yeah.
Talo honey and Fakalo Flahia to welcome back to another episode of Tau Tala Tala, where me and my famous friends get to help you with everyday issues. And we're really blessed because my panel's like Magic Mike. It's an all-male panel. And starting with the man himself, Stephen Lutua. And next on our panel, we've got my favorite singer of all time this evening, Darren Penepate. Tell me. And my favorite male actor slash dancer. What's your name? Jordan Malikolo Crookshank. Well, as you all know, ladies and gentlemen, this program is where you ask us any question about any life situation, and my panel and I will help solve those problems. And our question for this week's episode is...
Tell her, I just convinced the girl to go out with me. Can you please help me and tell me what the first perfect date would be?
Wow, that was a very interesting question, eh? What are your thoughts about that?
What's it called? I'm a huge fan of Batman.
I'm whatever Gotham needs me to be.
Yeah, so being a fan of Batman, you know, I just try to emulate him, what he does. Choppers, you know, aim high, do the different thing.
Oh, you aim me right. Aim high. And the whole year is going to be high.
Yeah, you come across as a real dark knight. Yeah. What about you, Darren? What is the perfect first date in your mind?
Well, you know, this is an interesting one. I think when you go on your first date, you shoot very, very low. Keep the bar low. You know, just go for a walk, hold hands. So after that, you'll always improve.
I love the holding hands. I don't know about the walking. What about you, Jordan? What's the perfect first date for you?
Well, I've dated a lot of brown girls. Just first date, didn't. But I'd bring treats.
You bring treats?
Yeah, because no one really teaches you about the first kiss, you know? Oh. So I'd just bring treats, you know, in this case we have biscuits. And I'd just place them, like if you're sitting in the car, just like place them on your body. Just, and then just put them on your shoulder there. Once you place the last one there, you just wait, finger them. Like
that's
that.
A good tip.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know if that actually works, but...
I think I might need more than three biscuits, yeah? Wow, those are some amazing tips. But I guess just in one sentence, each of you, what would you say, Steve, to Josh?
Pretty much watch anything about Batman, emulate Batman. Batman is life.
Darren, what would you like to say to Josh?
Simplicity is the key. Don't overcomplicate things. They just want a nice, simple first date.
And you, Chocolate Factory, what would you like to say to Josh?
Josh, bro, just be yourself, man, and use your manners heaps. Use your manners. Be nice.
Respect. This is so important. Well, there you've had it, Josh. Very important things. Try and copy back, man. Keep it simple. And make sure you respect. And for me personally, I think it's important you treat a woman the way that you want to treat a woman. So let's give it up for our panel. And we'll see you again same time next week with our Tau Tala Tala episode. Bye!
Ladies, what are your favorite places that you've been to?
I haven't been to many places. I've been to Hawaii, which was awesome. Rarotonga was beautiful. But I've got to say my favourite place would be Kaitiriti, which is in the South Island. It's a golden sand beach. It's beautiful.
I loved Bali. Bali was really beautiful. I spent a little bit of time there. It kind of reminded me of Samoa, and Samoa was probably like the top of the list for me.
Yeah.
Which is like a bit cliche, but it just feels like home, and it's so nice.
Matt, talking about home for me, it has to be Fiji. Going back and seeing my family. Mm. Yeah, you guys should check out my poly postcard. Here it comes. Bulabanaka freshies, I'm Gloria Blake, and this is my poly postcard from my homeland in Fiji. So my favourite, freshest things about these islands are the people.
Well, for me, my family is here. To see my dad and all my sisters and my brother, it's such a great experience.
And the things that also have the best Fijian flavour.
It's tamarind seed. And then you boil it down and you make chutney.
Yum. For the curry.
So my freshest thing is that I can get killer dressed up, but no matter what I'm going to, I'll still probably wear these bad boys.
We are sitting in the dark with a Bluetooth speaker in the middle of a power cut. Welcome to Fiji, everyone.
The interesting fresh produce, the fresh faces in the street, and the fresh performers. And most importantly, the fresh food. So guys, that's a little snippet of my kai in downtown Suva, one of the most colourful cities in the Pacific, where I am keeping it fresh. Vanaka vaka levu, guys.
Thank you guys so much for having us. It was really good to see you all and joining us for this feast.
I mean, come and have some if you want some. There's plenty of leftovers.
Loads of leftovers. Now,
here's what's coming up next week, guys. See you later.
Bye.
Yo, what up, it's your boys, Colin Keith. We're all the way from California, and we're here to share our love with y'all.
The One Love Festival this year is a little extra special because it's way, way bigger.
It kind of reminds us of our roots, and it's all embedded island reggae.
Take it easy, keep it fresh.